What the fuck? Shit. Where's Victor? Where's Victor? Where's Victor? What's going on, Victor? Come back to reality. What's going on?
What
do you got there?
No, I just got the new bass we're gonna be reviewing. You wanna know what it is?
Okay.
It's the Peavey Millennium BXP. Well, this is the SUPERMOD.
Let's do it!
This bass guitar, Victor.
Okay, so this is the Peavey Millennium BXP. I don't know what year this was like produced specifically, but I know it's like a much more budget instrument. Like considering the cheap hardware, the tuner's not that good. The bridge not that good. As you can see, some of the like the springs and the saddles are mismatched. That's because I changed out some of the intonation screws because you can see they're kind of stripping and such.
What kind of knobs do you got in here?
Absolutely none, because I haven't gotten a set of set screw, or a set of like solid shaft knobs.
Okay, because they got the little slashes in there, that means it wants you to screw it on with a thing.
Yeah, and, alright, this just has like, you know, 21 frets, a nice looking blue, like clear, like transparent blue with a flame maple top.
It looks a little bit different in person. On video, it's more blue.
Kind of like my strat. Yeah. But it looks like really black on camera.
In person, it's like a little bit more aquamarine. Yeah. There's a little bit of green in there.
Yeah, you can kind of see like a flame from the flame maple top.
It's a pretty good looking bass.
Yeah. And on the back, you could tell it's a top because the rest of it's just like straight.
So this is actually our first string through bass we're going to be reviewing, which should hypothetically... increase the scale length, right?
Not necessarily. Scale length is like from nut or to saddles.
It increases something, the tension.
I know it does have a little bit more tension compared to standard, which is really good for down tuning.
It should help out. I believe we are going to be tuning to drop F sharp later in the video, so we'll see. See how it holds up against the Squire here.
Yeah, let's kind of move away from the body. Actually, let's just make sure we got this is a. It's this 5-bolt neck attachment.
Kind of like Ibanez style, I think. That is just weird bass style.
Yeah. And, you know, it's a pretty modern shape. It looks pretty nice.
No skunk stripe.
Yeah, let's go to the neck. We got probably a rosewood or a laurel. It's probably a laurel fingerboard. Like, it's a darker wood, like, for a fingerboard. I'm not sure what it is.
It could be either or.
And on the back of the neck, the neck looks like it's made of really, really nice wood. At the heel of the neck, you can kind of see some bird's eyes, like, kind of going on here, and you see a couple flames.
Very nice figuring, I would say, yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, they have the cheap random die-cast tuners on the back.
Kind of hip-shot style.
Yeah, I'm probably going to get them replaced.
Distinctive PB headstock shape, yeah. And we'll get into the actual feel later, but this does a... really slick.
Yeah, it's a satiny almost. Oh, it's like in between a satin and a gloss.
Actually, fuck getting into the feel later. Let's get into the feel now.
But wait, we have to talk about the headstock itself that talks about the Peavey Millennium BXP. And it's got this weird, like, kind of like swoosh. It's kind of cool. You can see the wood through. And as you can see, it is a painted headstock. Like every other bass that I own myself has a painted headstock. But now, let's talk about the mods I've done to this bass. What isn't stock? So originally, the pickups were some random generic garbage set of like, ceramic J pickups. And it does have a 70s pickup spacing, so you get a little bit more growl.
What is the 70s pickup reposition? What's that?
So
it's just closer to the bridge.
It moves the bridge pickup just a little bit backwards compared to like a standard 60s, where it'll be like a little bit closer. and it offers a little bit more growl, kind of like for that Geddy Lee kind of tone. Or, if I recall correctly, I think Flea from Red Hot Chili Peppers also used a 70s kind of jazz bass. And, you know, with these pickups here are a set of EMG CSX, JCSX, I think it is.
So we actually did perform some mods on this bass, so it's definitely not stock. Yeah. We're just kind of showing off Victor's fucking bass monstrosity that he created.
This, as you can see, there's like scuffs in the bass from me being fucking terrible at doing Dremel stuff. And these are a set of EMGs, EMG JCSX. They're pretty good. I love them. They're really bright. And no one could attest, these pickups were really bright, and the tone knob did not really do much to really kind of darken the tone.
Like it worked well if you wanted, like, a cutting metal tone, but if you wanted anything else, it just wasn't really there.
Yeah. And that's why the second mod of this bass is a Lucid Hand NFP single, like, preamp. It's kind of like a tone knob on crack. So basically, you can roll what would be farther than like a tone knob. You can get really dubby tones. You can roll off all the high end, but the signature of the NFP preamp is it's like a wall bass like tone knob kind of thing, where if you pull up, it offers a gain boost, and right at the point of roll off, it does like a boost. It does like a gain boost, or it just does a boost. So what happens is, like, hold on, put the camera up real quick.
No pure tone output jack.
No pure tone. So what happens is, like, let's say you have it rolls down like that. That's the EQ curve. If you do this, like, have it pulled up like that, what it'll do is it'll go like that. It'll have a big spike just before it rolls off the frequency.
And I'm kind of lost here, so what we're going to do... We should be good to go, right? Would you like to show off the pickups and the preamp?
All right, so let's just do the standard, like, neck pickup. So that's with just the neck pickup solo. Here's both. All right, now let's go to the bridge.
Pretty cool. We got some fresh strings on here. We got some feedback in the comments. We didn't, but you know, it's good to have them fresh strings.
Now let's show off just how far this kind of goes. So I'm just gonna hit a high note here, or how about here? As you can hear that sweep, it's really, really like it goes really far. Like it has a very wide range, like. We could go like kind of neck pickup and get kind of like this.
So do you have it pushed down or pulled up right now?
I have it pushed down. This is just like
standard.
Yeah, just standard. Now, here's both pickups. Just like, let's say you want a thrashy tone, you could roll it down just a little bit.
Play pie fire with fire.
I don't know how to play fire.
Play that one Megadeth song that I forget the name of.
And that's pretty good for a thrashy tone, but if you want like a rolled off bridge pickup sound for like jazz or funk, I'm not super into the jazz stuff, but like. Now, let's show off the cool part of this preamp. It's engaged, so there's a gain boost. And right now, we don't have it rolled off, so it's gonna be extra bright, so like.
Hear that on just the bridge pickup.
Yeah,
pretty damn bright, if I do say so myself.
Now let's go to the neck pickup.
You won't be cutting through the mix, you'll be fucking disemboweling the mix. You're gonna find the mix's rotting corpse 6 months later, and it'll bear it.
So, I'd say it can't do the... It's not a super classic bass. It's definitely not. It, like, I'd say it's pretty versatile, because you can, you know, push it down and get the kind of...
Yeah, it's more of like a metal kind of style jazz bass.
You get kind of a rush thing if you wanted, or you could... Oh, could you hand me a pick?
Oh, yes, I could. This fucking guy with his demands. Alright, let's see what we can do. Yeah, just take it. Take the pick.
Alright, so if you pull it up, you could do some kind of tool stuff, or you know, you could kind of get a P bassy tone if you just roll it off a little bit with it pushed down, and you could do some. What I've been doing mostly is using this as like just my straight metal bass. Like if I roll off to the bridge and go just roll down the preamp just a little bit, you can get like some of the images and words from like Dream Theater type tone, like the.
That's pretty cool. So yeah, you didn't get to hear this thing before we added the preamp, but it was just very bright. I'm very impressed by the Lucid Hand preamp. It fucking...
It tames it.
It really added a lot of versatility too, like... We can get this to sound like an acoustic guitar, we can get this to sound like the floor. Alright, can I talk about the feel, Victor?
Absolutely.
Not to hijack the video here, but something about this bass, it allows you to set the action very low without getting like any unwanted buzz. So it's just like a really shreddy style guitar. It's also, it's got the jazz bass like string spacing, so you're really able to like, it's a very thin note width, it's like shredder's bass. It's awesome. You're really able to shred on this thing. It's very modern looking as well. Yeah, that's cool. It's always cool to... You know, I like higher action personally, but this definitely just makes it easy to do stuff like that. Now, as for the actual neck, I appreciate that there's no skunk stripes. Sometimes I just like to see a big chunk of wood with the brown thing sticking out. And the finish, I don't know what kind of finish is used on here, but it's really slick. Possibly the slickest we've reviewed on the channel. It's up there. Like, I'm able to just... So yeah, it's a very nice feeling bass. I haven't played this thing enough. How would you say like the tuning stability is?
It's okay, but if you put it in a room where there's frequent temperature changes, you're gonna be tuning very often.
Also, if you put it in a room with me, I'll just be like... Yeah, it feels great. I really like it. Do you want to try some down tuning out, Victor?
Yeah, it's got 45, it's got 40-100s on right now because I just didn't have any other sets of strings on hand. But this thing sounds absolutely fucking amazing with like just down tuned everything just straight up.
So I think we're coming up with this on the spot. I'm thinking we'll do a little drop D, maybe a little drop C sharp, and then we're going to drop F sharp. So we'll see how this thing holds up. Down tuned.
Alright, now let's drop this. Let's drop this down to B, actually.
Dropping down to B?
Just straight B.
Leaving the other strings the same?
Yep. So this is like some Tool kind of stuff. I think Tool people will know what this song is.
Oh shit.
And if we tune this down to E, we can get like bead tuned or whatever.
Bead.
Or whatever fucking.
No, it's not.
I forget what it is.
Bedga. Bedga tuning.
Alright, we're almost there.
So we've tuned pretty low. How is this handling the down tuning?
It's pretty good. It's doing good for, you know, a set of 40 to 100. Like, it's doing good just because, like, it's doing good for a lower tension set of string.
You know, if I didn't know any better, I would think this is a 5-string. No, alright, like we promised you guys, we are going to be tuning to drop F sharp now. So let me actually look up the notes in this tuning. You know, that's the harmonic trick if you just want to tune your bass and it won't pick it up. Either 12th fret or 5th fret. Well, I think we're about to invent a new genre of music.
Alright, what's the next one?
F sharp again. God, this tuning's so metal, I just threw up in my mouth. Should play Anesthesia. It doesn't sound as fucked up as I thought it would.
I haven't played this in forever, so I'm terrible at it.
Yeah, just play Freebird, bro.
I don't know that one either.
You gotta let your boy try his tuning out. How does this handle the F sharp tuning? What's the verdict on this?
This thing is definitely not set up for it because you can hear like tons of fret bows.
Right, you gotta let your boy try this out.
Now. It doesn't even sound like music anymore.
But for the other ones, it did handle down tuning pretty well.
Yeah, for 4200s, it did handle down tuning pretty well. Eventually I'll be replacing the tuners and the bridge. I might get a set of Graphtec ratio tuners or a set of Hipshot ultralights, or maybe even Goto reso lights.
Might make it like slightly more balanced.
It does have some neck dive due to how like light the body is.
It's very minimal.
But you're not fighting the neck at any point, are you?
I mean, usually you're touching it.
Are you fighting?
Definitely not.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
So I think with all that that drop F sharp tomfoolery out of the way, we can get into the actual sound demo. Let's do this, guys. Let's fucking go! Alright guys, well Victor's a fucking pussy and he fell asleep, so I'm just gonna ask you guys Can you just let us know what you think about this bass guitar in the comments? Is it good? Is it bad? Is it do you just not have like a particular interest in it? What do you think about this bass guitar?
All right, leave a comment.